It's strange that human beings have gone to the trouble of inventing strange, mythical beasts, like the Minotaur, the Chimera, and Sarah Jessica Parker. When in truth, there were already some really weird creatures beneath our feet the whole time, in the form of fossils and skeletons. Earth's natural history is an incredible story, with a cast of creatures so diverse, it makes the Oscars shortlist look as varied as a hillbilly gene pool. But every so often, there would come along a beast or bug that looked so peculiar it couldn't help but stand out from everything else on the Earth. So let's take a look at some such oddities in our list of seven astonishing creatures that once roamed the Earth. At number 7, Forestracet. When a creature's nickname is the Terror Bird, you know you're dealing with something nasty. And the Cenozoic era Forestracet were precisely that, and then some. These gigantic flightless birds existed for 60 million years, with the last estimated at 1.8 million years ago. Standing an imposing 3 meters tall, and capable of running at 50 kilometers per hour. Their razor-sharp beak and vicious talons were used to peck, kick, and slash their prey to death. Not that they had to dismember their dinner, as so large were these birds that the BBC once described them as being able to swallow a medium-sized dog in one gulp. And that is a unit of measurement I'll be using in everyday life from now on. I think us humans are pretty fortunate to not have existed around the same time as these bizarro versions of Big Bird, but actually the statement itself is still up for debate. It was once thought that humans never lived during the era of the Terror Bird, but several discoveries from Uruguay have now cast doubt on this, with some Forestracet remains allegedly dating back as recently as 17,000 years ago. That's barely a blip on the grand scale of Earth's timeline, so is there a possibility that these beasts still exist somewhere on Earth today? And if so, can I get a side order of their wings? At 6, Helicoprion. This ancient shark-like fish burst into existence 290 million years ago, and I think it's a pretty miraculous animal for two main reasons. First, it managed to survive the Permian-Triassic extinction, which killed off 96% of all marine life. And second, well, it's that badass underbite, isn't it? In ancient Greek, Helicoprion means spiral saw, and when you see an artist's depiction, it's hard to argue with that name. We only know of the Helicoprion bizarre dental arrangement, and indeed its existence, thanks to fossils of its teeth, since their cartilage-based skeletons have long since decayed. But even after multiple fossil findings, we still have no idea how these incredible tooth whorls would have worked. Some scientists think that the Helicoprion might have used its jaw as some kind of whip, but I like to imagine it was just coiled out and filled with tacos. And that is why I am not a marine biologist. Or skinny. Or not allowed in Taco Bell anymore. At 5, Hallucigenia. It's certainly not hard to imagine how this fella got its name, because it looks like someone tripped balls and drew a detailed depiction of Godzilla's junk. Hallucigenia was a type of marine animal that spontaneously appeared during the mysterious Cambrian explosion 542 million years ago. It was during this period that complex life forms were produced for the very first time. And it turns out that one of Mother Nature's most pressing engagements was to create this freaky creature. So what, on literal Earth, was it? Well, Hallucigenia were a simple worm that was no more than 3.5 centimeters long, and we think they are ancestors of the modern velvet worm. Each of its 14 to 16 legs had a pair of claws at the end, with every claw having its own backup claw ready and waiting inside the limb in case of injury. There's also a set of tentacles thrown onto the front of the creature just for good measure. At least we think it's the front. It could also be a tentacle-filled butt, because we've still not determined which way round the Hallucigenia actually goes. Number 4. Opabinia. The Opabinia single-handedly proves that Mother Nature has been messing with us since long before she got drunk and made the mongoose. These creatures, which lived on the seafloor around 500 million years ago, were considered a joke when first presented to scientists in 1972. And with its five stalk-like eyes, fanned tail, and large claw trunk complemented by a set of 30 lobes and 30 flippers, it's easy to see why. The Opabinia was only about 4 to 7 centimeters long, and since it didn't have legs, we think it moved around by creating tiny Mexican waves through flapping its many lobes as fast as it could. It may not surprise you to know that we still haven't precisely categorized this strange, ancient creature, but as we begin to explore its origins in greater detail, the Opabinia may help us to further understand the very nature of the Cambrian explosion itself. At 3, Longisquama. It is now widely believed that dinosaurs were once covered in a layer of delightful feathers. But they weren't the first reptiles to achieve this, with one of the earliest being the flamboyant Longisquama. These guys lived 230 to 240 million years ago, which was 70 to 80 million years before the first dinosaurs started sprouting feathers, and its translated name of long scales refers to the fact that they had large protrusions shaped like hockey sticks poking out of their backs. There's still some confusion over whether these structures were indeed feathers or they comprised something sturdier, such as a set of scales or fins. But either way, this guy looks impressive. I mean, how could you not look awesome with a full-body mohawk? At number 2, Quetzalcoatlus. I don't know how big you imagined ancient flying dinosaurs like the pterodactyl would be, but I had no idea they could give giraffes a run for their money in the long neck stakes. The Quetzalcoatlus was certainly the largest pterosaur ever to take flight, and quite possibly the largest animal ever to hit the skies as well, with these airborne abnormalities rocking a wingspan of over 11 meters wide at our most conservative estimates. These giant dino birds lived in North America around 99 to 55 million years ago, taking their name from an old Aztec serpent god called Quetzalcoatl. And despite their massive wingspan and that long-ass neck boosting their height to a freaky 3 meters tall, we think these flying giraffes weighed only 70 kilos. This gargantuan yet lightweight frame is so unique, it was once used as inspiration for DARPA as they sought to mimic the Quetzalcoatlus's aerodynamic nature when designing an experimental ornithopter drone back in 1985. And if there are any fellow picnic aficionados out there, you should be extremely glad that the Quetzalcoatlus isn't around today, because the two leading hypotheses regarding their lifestyle choices claim that they either roamed over land picking off small vertebrates for lunch, or that they ventured out to sea and the coastline looking for food there. Basically, Quetzalcoatlus were the seagulls of their time. And if one of these things was hurtling towards you on the beach, the last thing you'd be worried about is your sandwiches. And at number 1, Animalocaris. I'm not entirely sure how a lobster and a whale would be able to get their freak on. But if they could, the result would surely be this demented monstrosity. This early version Animalocaris lived 480 million years ago during the early Ordovician period. And thanks to a miraculously preserved three-dimensional fossil found in Morocco, we know that this creature had a very distinct feature which it used to collect food, namely, a giant sieve attached to its face. When it was time to feed, it would swim around and use its jaw-mounted net to scoop up as much plankton as it could, filtering out the seawater and leaving behind a pouch full of delicious sea organisms for dinner. And while its 2-meter size may not seem that impressive today, at the time of its existence, it was almost certainly the largest animal on the planet. And that's our list. I wonder what other astonishing creatures once roamed the Earth. Ones whose remains have been lost to decay for all time. And also, could any of these bizarre beasts still exist today?
Well, guess what?
Some of them might, because in our recent upload on the strangest seven things found in the ocean, we covered the coelacanth fish, which was thought to have died out 65 million years ago. Why not check that video out right now and see what else we've found lurking in the ocean deep?